All right, thanks a lot, Bob. So certainly a lot to dissect here. We'll start with the fact that this was a pitcher's game. The hitters didn't have that much luck. Let's talk about Gerrit Cole, 5 1/3 innings. He rang up the strikeouts and gave up the home run to Teoscar Hernandez, but certainly can't be disappointed by the way he pitched.
No, I mean, he's your ace. The thing that really went well, I thought that he and Gary Sanchez worked excellently together in terms of making quick adjustments on the fly. He threw more changeups in any one start than I've ever seen Gerrit Cole throw, and he made that adjustment quickly, and I think that was Gary Sanchez kind of prodding him to kind of mix it up more because he didn't have a good feel for a slider early in the game. That got better as it went on. The one mistake with the slider was obviously the hanger to Teoscar Hernandez, who hit a long way.
Now, Paul, you've been talking about how important a first month it's going to be for Gary Sanchez. So the first game of the first month, Yankees lose, but Gary Sanchez has to be pleased over the fact the home run. He called a very good game as well, threw out a runner at second base. All things considered, a great game for Gary Sanchez.
Well, on a scale of 1 to 10, obviously it's a 10 for Gary Sanchez today. You know, great at bats, big two-run homer, and I agree with Coney. It looks seamless behind the plate. Threw a runner at it second. He pretty much had an all-around great day, and hopefully this is the start of something for him.
Now, let me follow up with you, Paul. I mean, you have to sit there as a guy who dominated as a hitter in the big leagues and realize how tough it is to hit now. I mean, they keep bringing guys in from the bullpen, throwing 99-mile-an-hour fastball, 79-mile-an-hour changeups. We saw that with Julian Merriweather. The bullpen arms are pretty nasty around baseball.
No doubt about it. I mean, there were times that you could not wait to get into the, you know, the opposing team's bullpen. I don't even know if you want to get into the bullpens now. You just hope that the starter's bad enough where you score a few runs. I mean, the power arms, right-handed, left-hander, it does not matter. I mean, they are there for one thing, and that is to blow you away as a hitter. And it's very tough when you're facing three, four guys in a game with that type of stuff.
And it's a little unfair, too, David. I know both of us don't love the rule starting a runner at second base. Nick Nelson gets the loss. He struck out three batters. Yes, he did give up the double to Grichuk, but he pitched pretty well.
He did. Yeah, you know, he continued on what he showed in spring training. I mean, the stuff is there. I think the Yankee organization, rightly so, is very excited about his future. He threw the ball exceptionally well. One pitch. I mean, he would have pitched around it, you know, if it weren't a man on second. So that's the unfortunate part for relievers when they come into these type of games in extra innings with a runner already on second base that you had nothing to do with. Well, you know, he scores. That's on you.
All right, so the 2021 season begins. The Yankees lose 3-2 in 10 innings. Corey Kluber makes his Yankee debut on Saturday, and a full house here at Yankee Stadium, so we're returning to normal, Bob.